Alright guys, welcome back to another PS Plus monthly video. This is for March 2021. We're here with our first game today, Final Fantasy VII Remake. If you guys don't know how these videos work, I'm going to show you some, probably about 10-15 minutes of gameplay on each game, and then give you the rundown on each game at the end of that game's time on the video, or whatever you want to call it. I'll let you guys know if it's worth downloading, how I personally feel about it, and things like that. So let's hop straight into it. So, as you guys can see in the bottom left-hand corner, I played 5 hours of the game, and as of me filming, it came out yesterday on PS Plus. Which is saying a lot, because I don't play games much often anymore off-camera, and this game I'm playing all off-camera from now on. So, this game, to me, is insane. I love it. It's really cool. I was surprised too, because Final Fantasy 15 I liked, but it was nothing crazy, you know what I mean? This to me is insane. This is how games should be made, you know what I mean? But I'm gonna give you guys some information real quick about the game. So the remake came out last year in April. It's made by Square Enix, of course. It's Final Fantasy. And basically all I have about it, and it's also liked by everyone. Every single critic has enjoyed it. For my research. Do you have any new? No, okay. Me personally, I've been loving this game. Look at the graphics. It's insane. It has the same thing that I didn't like with Final Fantasy 15 though, with the hair. It's like super like pixelated or whatever you want to call it. Like you see all the fuzz on it. Final Fantasy 15's graphics were really fuzzy like that, and I hated it every second of those graphics. But we're here with this, and I've been having so much fun.
Mission starts the moment we board that train. You sure you ready for this?
Yeah. So this isn't probably the best place to film this little clip of it, but this is where I am in the story, so.
All we can do is hope.
Today really gotta be the day, huh?
Ain't no stopping this train we're on, son. A lot of people risk their lives to get it rolling. Already put the word out, more's coming too. Shut them all down by today, or we shut another down for you. Ain't on us, not us. Play it cool.
I think my favorite thing about this, that was the end of chapter 4. So yeah, I could have probably started it at a better place. But I think the thing I like about this game most is the actual setting itself. It's like, because as you guys know, Final Fantasy is a game where each game is separate from the last. It's massive, and they all take place in different worlds. This one's I would call it steampunk sci-fi type thing. Steampunk sci-fi fantasy, I guess you'd call it. I love it though. It's a great setting. Some of the other Final Fantasy that I played, Final Fantasy 15 was modern, but some of the other ones I played were more of just fantasy, straight up fantasy.
It's the same deal as last time.
So I love this setting a lot. Storage.
And then blew it all to hell.
I also just love the overall story of this game so far. The story is great. I played the original quite a bit, but I didn't get far into it at all. Because, I mean, when I was playing the original, I was like 6 or 7. I didn't understand how to play games fully. I mean, like, even going back now and playing games, like, wow, this is insane. So I don't trust my younger self with games. There's with barely anyone my on this first train, bare bone happy to be here. Judgment of a game.
Might stand out as a group.
Yeah, I don't trust my original Judgment games because I've gone back and played quite a bit of games and I just loved them. And I remember hating them as a kid. So I don't trust my Judgment at all. I think it's because I play every genre game. I have puzzles, I have shooters, I have RPGs, I have action adventure games, survival games, racing, sims, sports. I love all genres of games.
Here comes the first hurdle.
Not much of one.
I know, but that doesn't mean I don't have butterflies in my stomach.
Oh my god, I'm so sorry about the dogs. Roxy! Yeah, this isn't the best place to do it. You guys are just gonna see story content.
Would you mind keeping an eye on things the next car over? I'm worried there might be trouble.
Why's that?
Barrett's always on edge before missions. But you know he's a good guy underneath it all. The people on this train don't.
He'll be fine.
Maybe. But I won't be until I know for sure.
Be right back.
Thanks.
Yeah, so this is going to be a lot of just story content rather than fighting, combat type stuff. No, Barrett, shut up. I don't want to talk to you. I want to pick up the materia.
Those terrorists? Avalanche is a blight on Midgar.
Huh?
Their bomb threat has thrown our offices into chaos, let alone the reactor itself. It's total insanity! But we won't lose heart. No! Everyone at Shinra agrees. The reactor will stay online.
Is that right?
What? You got a problem with that?
Do I have a problem with that? Oh, you can bet.
He doesn't.
Asshole.
You know you're better than that.
Alright, I think we'll just call it here on this game and we'll head over to the next one. There's not going to be much except for story content for this game at the moment. So we're going to go ahead and head over to the next game now, which is Remnant from the Ashes. So I'll see you guys there in just 1 second. Okay guys, welcome to our second game. I'm gonna give you guys some info really quick before we hop into actual gameplay. So this is Remnant from the Ashes. It came out August 20th of 2019, and it's published by Perfect World Games, and it released with high ratings, with 8 out of 10 at IGN and 9 out of 10 at Steam. Oh, I just realized, I didn't tell you guys if you guys should download Final Fantasy VII or not. Yes, I thought that was obvious, but I forgot to state it. Download Final Fantasy VII. But we're gonna hop into this. We're gonna hop into this right now. So, a little rundown, because I didn't explain Final Fantasy VII as much, because I think it's very understandable what it is. It's a Final Fantasy game. I feel like it's a very known game franchise. Maybe not on the Western side of things, but it's a very Westernized game at this point. I mean, their first few were very Eastern, but... Oh, I said that... No, I said that right. Never mind. But they're very Westernized now. It's a very watered-down East RPG, but I'm gonna explain what this game is. It's basically a Souls-like with guns. You got your bonfires, you got your hard game with death everywhere. it's very much a Soulsborne. It's a Soulsborne third-person shooter at heart. The entire game is actually procedurally generated, like each map you play on. The story stays the same in general missions and things like that, but the world themselves are procedurally generated, the layout and what loot is in that world. which I find really cool because that means I could play each of the three classes and have a different experience every time. But you see what I mean? Like, that's straight up a bonfire. But I actually enjoy this being a Souls-like because I've recently started getting into Souls-like games again. And that I just love them. I started playing Bloodborne again, and oh my god, Let It Die, which I don't know if you call it a Souls-like. It's kind of a Souls-like, but Let It Die, it's a free-to-play PS4 game. I played quite a bit of that the other day for like 6 hours straight, and oh my god, it was fun. But like, this game has the whole shebang. It has dodging, it has a stamina bar, it has bonfires. It's a Soulsborne at heart, and it's very challenging. Hopefully we don't run into anything too challenging here at the moment, because I'm not really prepared for it when it comes to weapons and armor and things like that. You know? And actually, it's not even those. Our weapons and armor is pretty good for where we are right now. It's the fact that I don't have resources. But I don't plan on making. Oh shit! I don't plan on making any videos on Final Fantasy VII on the channel. I do plan on maybe making a few on this game though, because I feel like it's something we could hop into for a random game video and just play a little bit of. So I definitely want to do that at some point. I don't know when yet, but yeah, so be on the lookout for this on the channel. Final Fantasy VII though is a game I'm going to take my time with and play on my own time. Just because it's a longer game, plus we already have so many series built up on the channel just waiting to be filmed. So I'm going to play Final Fantasy VII on my own time. There might eventually be a Road to Platinum video, I just don't know when that'll happen. God damn it, the dog. Roxy! Oh my god. Well, you guys are going to hear the dog in the background this whole time, I'm so sorry about that. But, yeah, so eventually there might be a Road to Platinum video for Final Fantasy VII, but at the moment it's not planned. This game, on the other hand, I want to make quite a few videos on, just because it's something that I think I could definitely get into. It's something that, I mean, right now, currently, I'm loving. I played this game, as you guys saw on the title screen, I played it for like 2 hours when I initially downloaded it. So, I mean, I've been playing a lot the last, like, 3 or 4 days.
This is good.
Shit. I've been playing a lot, though, on my own time the last, like, 3 days or so. Dude. But I've been playing this the last few days. I've been playing two different Kingdom Hearts games. I started Final Fantasy VII, which the cool thing about playing Final Fantasy VII and Kingdom Hearts at the same time is there's so many similarities, so I don't, like, I'm not shuffling on too many different controls and different gameplay mechanics at the same time because they're so similar. I don't have to worry too much about that. Oh yeah, we picked up a thing, a trait. So I don't have to shuffle around too much when it comes to controls and game mechanics because there's so many similarities between Final Fantasies and Kingdom Hearts, because of course Kingdom Hearts came from Final Fantasy. But yeah, so I didn't know there was anyone behind it. But yeah, so I've been playing those, then I've been working on the Platinum for Assassin's Creed 3. That's just taking a little bit because I'm just taking my time with the Platinum. I don't want to rush it or anything like that. And then I'm gonna work on Darksiders soon. I don't know when, because Darksiders is gonna take a little while. Mainly because I don't fully understand what trophies I have to do. There's quite a bit of weird trophies that are missable, so I have to make saves in certain parts so I don't miss them, and I'm just trying to figure out where I need to make saves and all this other crap. Are you serious? See, I'm using my ammo very unwisely.
Oh,
I'm almost out of long gun ammo, which is not good because you don't get much ammo for it. I have an ammo crate consumable, but I don't want to use it unless it's absolutely necessary, which I just don't want to use it, okay? As you guys can see with this game, there's a little more I can film because it's all action. Really, there's not too much story to it. Those damn dogs, dude. But there's not too much story to it, so it's quite nice for when it comes to filming videos like this, where it's just short me telling you, showing off some gameplay. Because, I mean, Final Fantasy VII, a lot of it is story, which is really nice. I don't like it. Where'd he go? Dude, there's so many of them. Well, that's a good place to end anyway. Because it's restarting all the way back from start. But we're going to head over to our last game. This game is also definitely worth a download. I've enjoyed it quite a bit lately since I've downloaded it. So definitely worth a download. I'll see you guys in a second with Maquette. I don't exactly know how to say it. I haven't played it yet, so we're going to enjoy that together. But I'll see you guys there in a second. Okay, guys, we're here with Maquette. It's a puzzle game. I don't know anything about it yet, except that this was a day one release, exactly like Destruction All-Stars and Oddworld is going to be in April. It was a day one release for the PS5 version of this game. Oddworld's a PS5 exclusive, and we get that in April, and... Yeah, I don't know exactly what to expect, other than it's a puzzle game, which, I don't know, my brain instantly goes to, The Witness or Rhyme, because it's just an indie game, and I love these little indie games we get out of PS Plus, because we've gotten quite a bit of good ones. Okay. Oh. Okay. Okay, hold on, though. Hold on. What can we do all in here? I like just instantly messing with settings. Oh, yes. Yes. Did I turn it on or not? No. I like instantly messing with settings in games. just to make sure. Like, that's the first thing I did with every game. Okay. Let's hop into it. I love the music. I lost my keys last night, so I turned everything inside out trying to find them. This is so cool. I like this. This is also like a 6-hour plat or something like that. So I'll probably platinum it at some point in time. We can do a little jump. Sit down on this side. I like it. In my search, I came across a box that was long overdue to be opened. So Square's the interaction button, it looks like. Look at it. Look at all the little... The art style's so nice. It's pretty. Look at the forgotten objects from our life together. Graveyard of Afirma, a jumbled timeline. Oh, the guitar solo goes hard. God, bro, like, this is something I want to add to my Spotify playlist. Matches from that fancy place with noodles, you like. Some old records we picked up on Sunday thirstorm trips. Novelty glasses I broke when I was too drunk at the New Year's party and panicked on the roof and you calmed me down. This is nice. Oh, the song's over. Oh, there's crickets. Oh, I love that. Just crickets in the background, just chirping. I don't know if you guys knew that, but it's from them rubbing their legs together. They don't actually vocalize it. Oh, there's some frogs. Oh, that's so pretty. Like, if I had this as like a, what is it? What are they called? Like a active wallpaper or whatever, with this sound in the background of just the water flowing and the frogs and just the different fireflies moving and the water moving, this would be the sickest background ever, dude. There's probably cooler backgrounds with like fishing, but like, I don't know, it's this art style, it's just so nice. It's, I don't like the music though, but it's also cool because it lets me listen to the water flowing and the frogs. What does that sound the frogs make? What is it called? I feel like it starts with like a C or something. A toy block from that hilarious English. Disastrous weekend we tried babysitting your nephew. English is hard for me, okay? Some words I can't pronounce, so I don't even try. It's just like sometimes my, I don't know, I slur on certain words and I can't pronounce certain words right if they have certain vowels and things like that. And between a handmade birthday card, a filthy guitar pick, Monopoly houses. I found our sketchbook. See, this apparently is a puzzle game, but that's not the vibe I'm getting. I'm getting like an indie just story game. The one we would take turns drawing in back when we didn't know each other's secrets. Ooh, so you two have secrets. I found my keys, but I missed my train. I'm this is one of those games where I feel like it could scare you just halfway through. You know what I mean? Just very unexpected vibes. Okay, so I can... Just hit square, okay. Circle. Okay. So there's like a little element to you actually interacting with objects. You can drop and you can point them and shit. Oh, do I gotta get the key out of here? You know how quirkous animation would make me piss off? I mean, it works for this game, but like any other game, that would piss me off. I'm gonna keep that key. It's a precaution. Oh, look at that. Dude, I love this too, because last month we had Concrete Genie as like sort of the indie game, and it was phenomenal. And I think this will be the same way. This is so cool. Even though it seems like there might be an overarching story, but it's very subtle. But this is so cool. I just couldn't stop turning the pages and looking at what our past selves were capable of imagining. This is just so cool to me. I love indie games so much. The maquette. Yeah, I love indie games. Preferably ones like this where it's first person rather than them being like side-scrolling. I do prefer these little first-person games. Okay. Wait, what are we in right now? It looks like it goes on forever. I know there's some sort of thing where there's world inside a world inside a world, so whatever you do in the smallest world will affect all the other worlds, things like that. I don't know fully how it works just yet, but I know there's something those lines.
Do you mind if I sit here?
Oh, there's actually voice acting.
Oh.
So it's a love story from the looks of it.
Oh.
Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry.
No, don't worry. It only spilled a little.
I'm such a klutz. Is your sketchbook okay?
Yeah, unscathed. It's just doodles anyway.
Can I see it?
Oh.
Oh, this is a cool castle.
Thanks. I just started drawing again. I used to sketch constantly, and then, I don't know, I just stopped.
So did I. I mean, there was a time in elementary school when I was the girl who was good at drawing.
The girl who was good at drawing? I remember that girl.
Everyone was always like, oh, please, will you help me with my poster?
How do I draw hands?
Exactly. I was like, I don't know how to draw hands. I'm 5 years old.
Well, let's see how far you've come since your toddler years.
Okay.
You're drawing it upside down.
Hey, there is no right or wrong way to draw in a sketchbook.
Okay, that's fair.
Oh, wow, that's my order. That was fast. I'm Kenzie, by the way.
I'm Michael.
It's nice to meet you. I just gotta run.
Bye, Kenzie.
It seems so wholesome. I love it. I genuinely love that little voiceover thing right there. I don't know if you'd full on call that a cutscene, but that was awesome. Why aren't more people talking about this game? Maybe it's just me. Maybe I just love indie titles that much, but this is, ooh. I don't know why more people aren't talking about it. That was such a cool little scene. Well, you got the little art going on. So this is where we are. Correct? We need a key. Is there a key over here somewhere? Can I lift this up? No. Wait, but I can mess with it in here, right? Or... Where'd it go? Okay, what do I want to do with it? That's not what I want to do with it. I gotta figure out where I need to put it. I guess I don't have a big brain, huh? Where would it be locking the key at? Where, like, do I see anything that I maybe could crush with this? Because I would assume it has to be within this vicinity, correct? Because, yeah, I can't even go back this way. So it would have to be in this vicinity of, like, what needs to be destroyed. Oh, these corners have, like, pressure plates. From the looks of it. So if I... How do I rotate it? Oh, there we go. Damn it, I still messed it up. It needs to go a little further out. Why is this the game we've played the longest? Like that? I completely missed the pressure plate. Whatever. Oh, wait. Wait, was this open the whole time? Oh. Will that work? Yeah, so for some reason, this is the game we've played the longest. Yeah, no, that did nothing. Shit, am I stuck down here? Oh, we got a bridge. We got a bridge. We got a bridge, boys. Take me up. Yeah, I don't know why this is what we're spending the longest time in, but I think it's because Final Fantasy, if I played that game any longer, I would have ended up playing it all day. Let me just move this. I think the concept for this is so cool as well. Just the whole... basically... a world inside a world scheme. I think that's so neat. Oh, there we go. Boop. Well, there has to be a purpose, right? There has to be a purpose to me doing this. Oh, it goes up. Okay, I thought it was gonna go down. I was like, there's no point in doing that. Oh, what the fuck? Who are you? More music. Coming in so close. So close. You might scare me. Oh, her vocals are fire. Oh my god. I think I know your face. Your smile. Dude, I love it. The beat of your heart against mine. Yo, this song goes hard. But oh. There's no escape. I love this game. This is so cool. Goodbye to the day. I'll hide in my dreams. Wrapped up in tidal waves. Oh, I love it. Why do I love it so much? Oh my god. This is so cool. Let me get this hard. After this song, we'll end the video. Oh. Then here you come with your snake's tongue. And on whatever you pray, I got some. Cause oh, maybe I'm damned to. Monsters and men, the places I've been, my dreams are awful bad. don't even care if I get copyrighted strike. Music's so good.
So tonight I'll take my leave. The strike's bleeding hard from my sleep.
That's so cool.
Drown me on the ocean floor. But when I choke on salt, I beg for more. 'Cause oh, there's no escape. 'Cause you're here to stay. Goodbye to the day. I'll hide in my dreams, wrapped up in tidal waves.
What is going on here? Okay, the song's over. I said I was gonna stop the video. Oh wait, I need to put this in the normal side. Oh, okay. Oh, I have to pick you up the right way. That's why it's dragging like that. That song was so fire, dude. This is like, you guys probably won't feel the same way, but this is like the coolest game I've ever played. Not the coolest, but it's up there. So how do I get this into there? Is my question. How do I do that? Oh, I can walk in here. Okay, that's cool. I can just walk up in here. So how am I gonna get that into there, guys? Because that, it's clearly there on the thing. Maybe not. Maybe that's more like a ticket rather than this. I would assume it'd be that, though, because you need a key to get over there. We've already been over there. I don't know. But that's going to do it for this game. I mean, in my opinion, this is worth a download. To other people, probably not. It might just be because I like indie games, and the music is so good, in my opinion, for this game so far. And I like the love story that's going on. I'm a sucker for love stories, you know? But, either way, that's gonna have to do it for this PS Plus video. So, in my opinion, I mean, I'm loving every game that's come out. There's also one more, it's Farpoint, it's a VR game. I don't have VR, so I can't film it for you guys. But nonetheless, I think all these games this month are a keeper. And worth at least adding to your library. So with that said, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed. Please comment down below what you guys want to see on the channel in the future. And like and subscribe. And I'll catch you guys very soon in the next one. Stay safe out there, guys. Peace.